you've finished the parking lot, use the region tool again to trace out the do not disturb area, and take those existing grades in that area and make them proposed elevations. Then use the pan tool located along the top to enter the pan in the top right. Be sure to enter in the final floor elevation of 13.5 and add 6 inches of concrete and 6 inches of crushed stone to the proposed subgrade materials. You'll notice that when we entered the pad, we entered a final floor elevation. However, when entering the driveway in the parking lot, we did not. Regions take their elevation based off surrounding inputs. While topos will generally take care of elevations, they aren't the only tool. For this particular driveway, we'll want to take advantage of our connected spot routine to elevate evenly between 14.6 and then 18.3, and then up to 22.9, and then going back down along the other side. To do this, we'll select the connected spot routine, select connected spots, we'll do proposed, and we'll use existing trace. Select OK, select the perimeter of the driveway, then select the next button. Now, you'll notice that your cursor is locked on this line with the blue cursor. Move down to any of the elevation callouts and simply left-click them and enter the elevation. Once finished, select the green check mark. Now that we have our driveway finished, it's time to handle this shear elevation drop. You'll notice that along this line we have 2 separate elevations for each different side of our wall. To handle this, we'll use our wall routine located here. This will be a proposed wall, and this will just be a wall. We'll select the start point up here. We'll come down to this corner, and we'll tie it in to this 14.6. We'll select the next button, and then you'll notice it's going to ask us to choose either side of the wall to designate a side A. Let's go ahead and enter here in this area to designate these elevations as side A by left clicking. Then we'll come up here and select the top. And you notice side A is 12.9. And we're going to go ahead and make side B here 12.9 as well. Now, simply follow the elevation callouts along the line, and do take into account items such as this 8-foot topo along the border down here. And again at the end, do 14.6 for both sides. Go ahead and complete that. With the wall routine complete, we're actually finished inputting elevations on our sample takeoff. If you wish to stick around to learn how to use the Analyze feature to analyze your takeoff, or the Generate feature to view the reports, please stick around for more.